So what we're going to do, we're going to march the battalion over there. We're going to give them the opportunity. If they take it, they can go.
Okay, good.
At approximately 4 o'clock, 4:15 this afternoon, we will return. And if everything like the last lot we had last year, there will be a battle. But because they're not very good, they're just criminals, they will be put to death. So ladies and gentlemen, if you listen to this, if you can hear the magistrate, the exact words that he says is what happened up until 1843. Gentlemen.
Our sovereign law.
Not yet, sir.
Sorry?
Then you want to tell Sir Nothing, you said he's a law by this.
Are you?
Yeah.
Good.
Okay. Ready, third. Right fist. Ready, third. In command time. Forward. March. Right shoulder. Right shoulder! Forward!
During the time of the Napoleonic Wars. Tell you a little bit about...
Hello, darling.
Boys. Gentlemen. When we do that, gents. Boys. Okay. Leave the flag off. You'll see here, boys and girls, this is the flag known as the King's Colour of the Regiment. So we're all looking at quite a few children here today in school. Can any of you see any problems with some of the words that's written on this flag? In particular, have a look at the word Egypt. See how the word is spelled? E-Y-G-Y-P-T. This regiment had fought against the French in Egypt and was awarded a battle honour. So when this flag was done in 1809, the gentleman who did it and embroidered that had never seen the word. So it was misspelled. But it was deemed to be a very bad omen to change the flag. So this regiment carried this colour through the peninsula to a battle called Waterloo. If you see it, it's what's commonly called now the Union flag. It consists of the cross of St. George, the cross of St. Andrew, that's the red going from side to side, and the cross of St. Andrew. What's not on here, ladies and gentlemen, is the flag of St. David, the gold cross on the black background. Which is why that's not, is when Wales was incorporated into England by Henry VIII, at that time, they just had the flag of St. George. That was carried by an officer, usually the youngest in the regiment, most expendable. If you can imagine the regiment in those days, 600 to 800 men, this flag and another flag in the centre. It was used, that's hence the term troop in the colour. That's what they knew when their regiment was to stand. If that officer got shot, somebody else would take his place. When they ran out of officers, they used the sergeants. This officer, because he is an officer, has what they call a gorget. That's the last remnant that they wore from the knights in armour. You turn around, sir. Those of you who may have served in the regiment will see him. The Royal Welsh Fusiliers has a sash. That was awarded to the regiment because it was one of the last regiments to cut their hair. Prior to the 1800s, all British soldiers had long hair or they had to wear a wig, which was powdered white and oiled. And that was over their tunic and that prevented yet being messed about. This officer carries it today. All the soldiers carry it. If you turn around, quickly through it now, then you go back. What you see are fusiliers. These are the privates of the regiment. They wear red. That was the colour of the British Army. The day at that time wasn't good. So if it rained, it's a woolen jacket, the dye would run. They wear white trousers. They would become pink. So it was called not so much the thin red line, but the thin pink line. They wear a fusilier cap, not a bearskin. At the time, they would be made out of bearskins. Today, those that are not artificial Icelandic sheep. We don't look to keep them protected. Each regiment has a colour. The Royal Welsh, being a Royal Regiment, is blue. Gentlemen, those who can, please fix bayonets. Fix bayonets. They carry a gun that was accurate to about 50 yards. They could fire 3 rounds a minute. The French, 2 rounds a minute. British Army was the only army that fought in 2 lines. So every one of them could fire a gun. On top of the gun, the brown bash won't be much longer. We're going to shoot the cocker there. They carry a bayonet. The bayonet's there to frighten somebody. It's also there, unfortunately, to stab somebody. Triangular sticks in somebody, and that's the end of that. Ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon we'll be trying to put paint on this lot. We will have a competition. See how many of these can fire 3 times a minute. I won't go any longer. I can't compete with the band. But those who are about, please, 4 o'clock, come back. You can help us in the firing competition. And then you can see what happens to those people who break the King's law. And the King at this time
gentlemen, on behalf of the 23rd Royal Welsh Fusiliers, thank you very much. Anybody want to ask us questions after, please do so. If not, we'll see you back here at 4 o'clock, and then we'll see gifts and garters everywhere. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. 23rd, we move the cleaners. Ready, third. Shoulder.